I'm Jane Hislop and I teach in the School of Art and I teach illustration at Edinburgh College of Art.
I'm Elizabeth Cornby-Lawrence and I'm Rare Books Librarian in the University Library. Well, the origins of the project was an idea of mine because this must be the most magnificent architectural space the university has. And for a century and a half, this was the university library. Then, of course, in 1967, the books were moved out across into the current main library. But many of them still are shelved according to shelf marks that were used in here. So, and I now look after those parts of the collection. And you can now still see the arrangement that used to be in here. You can see the subjects and how things were grouped. And mentally, you can put the books back into this space. And it really haunts the imagination. And I had the idea that we could work with the collections and with some of the artists to bring some sense of the collections and what used to be here back into the space. So came to talk to Jane that we've worked with before to see what we could do.
The students involved, as I say, are all third year School of Art students. So they come across from a range of different disciplines. So involved in the project, we have painting students, photography students, and students from Intermedia as well. So they're all coming thinking about things from a different perspective. So they were introduced to this and then they selected to come on the project, and initially we brought them to the Playfair and most of them hadn't ever been before, even although it's part of the university campus, and they were really kind of awestruck with the interior and the potential, thinking about all of this knowledge that once was here and how the university has been established and how students across the years would have worked in here, and then how these volumes, all these books had then been extracted from here and exist elsewhere. And they were really excited to think about all of the books and some of them about the actual space as well.
Well, the real challenge for the students was when we then took them across to the Centre for Research Collections in the main library and showed them a few volumes from the collections so that they had a sense of what might be available to them and what sort of things they might be able to use. And then we introduced them to the difficult bit, which is working with the old catalogues, because in order to recreate the library, you have to engage with the documentation that existed when it was in use. And I think for many of them that was a huge challenge. So we left them to choose their own books, their own material. We gave them as much help as we could. There were a few occasions when we had to go and bail somebody out who'd got in a terrible pickle. But on the whole, they went away and did their own thing and took up the hints that we gave them to find other resources to give them a way into the catalogues and into the collection. And they've really, really surprised us with the range of books that they've used. They haven't gone for the obvious things by a very long way.
Yeah, and there are many really lovely records that the students have offered us of their research, and we can see on the shelf lists, they've got their little notes and how they're searching through and finding the different things that they're interested in. Mm-hmm.